Track number 3 on side 1, Italo-American Wedding, Every Time I Look in Your Eyes. This was composed and conducted by Carmine Coppola for the Godfather's Family Wedding album, and would soon make a reappearance in a different arrangement in the movie The Godfather Part II, and also on its soundtrack, but as a mashup with Nino Rota's After the Party, where it features some mandolin towards the end of it. In this version, the mandolin plays non-stop. Let's look at how to play this one, beginning with the tuning. We're in standard G, D, A, E. We're going to be playing almost every single note of this piece with continuous tremolo. The intro goes as following, and I'll be playing each part before breaking it down for you. Before we pause for a moment as only the trumpet plays. We begin on the 4th fret of the A string, followed by the open string, 6th fret D, 4th, then slide it down to the 3rd, and slide the 4th up to the 6th. Play it slowly. And after those 2 seconds of trumpet, the mandolin comes back in. For which we begin on the 5th fret of the A, followed by the 1st fret on the E, 6th fret A, 2nd fret E, back to the 6th fret A. 3, 4, 5, 6, 1st fret E, 6th fret A, 4, 3, 1, 6th fret D, 6th fret G. 3rd fret A, 6, 4, 1st fret E. 6th fret D, 4th fret A, 1st fret E, 3rd fret A, 4, 1st fret E, 4, slide the 4th up to the 8th, 9, 13, and slide that down. We continue. So you notice that we are not playing everything after the brass section. We have a trumpet leading here, and there's also a guitar and a bass, keys and drums playing in the background, but the trumpet is really the leading instrument, but the mandolin is playing its own lines. So for this we begin on the 6th fret of the E string, 5, 6, 9, 6, 4, 2, 1, 1st fret A, 4, 6, 2nd fret E, back to the 1st fret A, 2, 3, 6th fret D, 1st fret A, 4, 1st fret E, 3, 1, 3, 2, 4, 3, 2, open, 1. The next segment is repeating exactly what we've learned before here, the second and third bars. Before moving on to the next part, starts on the 4th fret of the E, 5, 6, 2, 3, open, 1, 4, 1, 5th fret A, 3, 5, 2, 1, 3, 6, 3, 1, 4th fret D, 5th fret G, 2nd fret D, 3, 4th fret E, 2, 1, 4, 1, 4, 1. The next segment being an almost identical repetition of the second and third bars. So rather than playing or F note up here on the first fret of the E string, we're going to be getting it by sliding the 6th fret of the A up to the 8th. And then commencing as before. The next segment, once more being an almost identical repetition to what we've learned, this time dealing with a 4th bar, with a small variation. So rather than playing to get from that initial sixth to the final first fret, we just play, holding the tremolo on the ninth fret, not playing the sixth, fourth, and second frets now, and immediately going down to the first instead. And then continuing the rest as before. Now once more, what we've learned in the second and third bars, but with more variations this time. Again repeating. This time cutting it off here at the third fret of the A, rather than now going down to the first and then adding in the six frets on the D and the G. We cut this out. We repeat. This time, rather than immediately playing tremolo on the fourth fret of the A, we play the third fret before plucking the fourth fret fast three times, then to the first fret E, third fret A, fourth fret A, first fret E, fourth, this time not sliding it, immediately up to the eighth, ninth, and 13th. Again, not sliding it this time. And lastly, would you believe it, another variation, this time of a fifth segment. So this time, rather than beginning on the 4th fret of E, we begin on the 5th one. Repeat as had. This is what we have learned so far, which we will now be following up by moving back down to the second fret of the D. 3, 5, 6, third fret A, 4, and then we play a quad, which is the sixth fret on the G, the third fret on the D, the fourth fret on the A, and the first fret on the E. This is just a C-sharp slash F, this is not really a chord, this is more of a power chord, right? Which we strum once, before moving back to tremolo on the 3rd fret of the D, followed by the 6th. After we've had that for a moment, we'll be adding in the 6th fret of the G along with it. Play both strings. And after we've had that for a moment, we'll be ending on just the 6th fret on the D. As the song fades out.